Until they start running up.
Welcome everybody.
Let's welcome
tonight's
the
home opener for the 2015 season of the Fighting Scots football team, as the Fighting Scots are ready to take on a rebuilding South Christian Sailor team at Ralph E. Meyer Stadium. Ryan, got a beautiful night for football.
It's perfect. We don't want to wish the summer away, but it's nice to be back watching a little football, that's for sure. But yeah, time goes fast. But kind of an old rival here. We're back playing again in South Christian. They picked them up last year, right? I think there was a time off where we didn't play them for a year or so.
Yeah, there was a time that they, Caledonia and South Christian were in the same conference back in the old Cape Gold days at one time. But this is a, like you said, Brian, a big rivalry game, a neighborhood rivalry, so to speak. But Caledonia had the upper hand last year, thoroughly dominating South Christian 47-21. But after that game, South Christian went on a tremendous roll, winning 12 straight games, which led them to the state four state championships.
Yep, absolutely.
Well, Brian, Caledonia was very impressive in last week's victory over Battle Creek, Harper Creek, a very physical performance by the Fighting Scots, and we look forward to a lot of that, seeing a lot of that tonight, as Caledonia, again, one of the more physical teams that you're going to find in the entire area.
Yeah, and usually we don't get to say this, but they're relatively good size this year, too. They're not real small. They got a lot of guys 215 to 220 and bigger all across, and they're pretty athletic, too. So that's really kind of a different deal here. Usually we're a little on the smaller side. Always tough, though. Caledonia's always tough up front. But
South Christian coming off a tough loss last week, 34-28. To Grand Rapids Christian, they put on a furious comeback, but it fell just short. So they're trying to set the record straight tonight and even up their record. But on paper, it looks like it's going to be pretty rough seas for these Sailors tonight, going up against a really tough offensive and defensive front for Caledonia.
Absolutely. And like you mentioned, too, you can tell not a lot of numbers out this year. That's a relatively small team number-wise over there. And
Tom Burrell.
Well, the Sailors do have a lot of talent, though, still on the team. They did lose 18 starters from last year, but quarterback Eric Dykstra,
and defend the South
can look forward to him throwing the ball quite a bit. One of his favorite receivers, Jake Nightwood. On the Caledonia side, we look for Caledonia to establish that patented run game and then just break something open with the pass.
Yeah, I'm sure they're going to run a combination. Last year they started off running that spread a little bit, and I'm sure you're going to see spread tonight, too, but you know, I don't know if they get in trouble again, they go back to their bread and butter at physical wishbone attack. But we'll see how it goes. But we're going to see them right away on offense.
Yeah, Caledonia will be receiving the kickoff. Saw Christian kicking off, defending the north end
Drake
zone.
Ellen's back deepest to receive the kick.
The boot, it's a high end over end kick. Taken at the five.
Got a little bit of a seam.
Drake Ellens on the return over the 30.
Take the opening kickoff.
Good field position to start this opening drive for the Fighting Scots.
Caledonia takes over first and 10 at about the 31-yard line.
We'll see Tanner Christian at the quarterback position for the Fighting Scots. He had a very good game last week, 10 out of 11 passing.
Well, we watched him a few times last year, too, in and out, and he's very accurate. He's a very good athlete. So they don't.
Tanner strong Christian runner,
is
too.
The quarterback for Caledonia.
Christian's just going to keep it. He's breaking the tackle. Gets out near the 40.
Tanner Christian keeps the ball up the middle. Brought down by number
33. Spot it right at the 40.
Holst.
They'll give him about 8 yards.
The second down and two.
Again, a good front push by that offensive line.
I was kind of wondering if South would come out a little bit on fire here trying to make a statement, but I think Caledonia size-wise up front is across the board is going to be a little bit bigger. They may have a couple guys, but center's Velting, I believe, and he's a
senior.
Senior
right
been there.
Him is Gorby, and those are two You're going to see all conference players. They may be a little higher. They may be vying for all state when this is all said and done. They're poised to have great senior seasons, as this entire offensive line and defensive line is. Some issues with the clock. It's still stuck at 12 minutes, so we have a little delay here.
Officials are going to be checking their watches and personal clocks, see if they can get it straightened out. Like you mentioned, Jerry, though, this group's been good, pretty athletic all across the board, all the way up through every class. Now that a lot of them are together, juniors and seniors, big senior class this year, and that's been a good group all along here.
Back along with Christian will be Bailey Kintzer at running back. Bailey had a good game last week.
A little different, you know, as high school, you know, that your team kind of changes a little bit. Last year, a big power runner with speed. This year, a little smaller, but kind of the scat back kind of thing, quick, a little fast, not going to run people over, per se, as last year.
Well, when you lose a guy like Eddie Kelly, you lost something. That's the kind of kid you just don't. Replaced with another kid. Caledonia's going to do this probably more by committee this year, but they've got a fine stable.
Yeah, they got a group there that can really help out. So, looks like they got it adjusted, and we're underway again.
He's going to hand off to Kintzer. He's going to be dropped at the line of scrimmage. He was hitting the backfield, but Bailey struggled back to get to the line of scrimmage, so it's going to bring up third down and short.
No gain, be third down.
Didn't get a chance to watch them last year. I hear they come out in their wishbone set. So you kind of figure there'd be some mix of that.
Just a keeper by Christian. He's got the first down.
Number 10,
stretches
Tanner
for an extra
Christian
yard.
Carries for a first down.
That's good. Caledonia's going to mix that up a little bit, not always in the spread, not always in the wishbone. It's going to keep some defenses guessing a little bit. It gives you that advantage.
First and 10 for Scots.
Caledonia keeping it on the ground. The three straight rushing plays resulted in their first down of the evening. Drake Ellen's wide to the right for the Fighting Scots. Again, another keep by Christian. Breaks a couple of tackles. The ball comes
out.
Tanner Christian was the ball carrier. There
I think Caledonia recovered it. I don't see South acting like they got it. They'd have the best view over there. Looks like Caledonia was able to maintain possession.
Justin Zoet falls on the ball.
Well, the ball did come out. Zoet fell on it for the Fighting Scots. So the Fighting Scots will retain possession. Gain of about a yard, though, on the play. So second down, 9. Just underway here, first quarter. Caledonia on their opening drive. Christian on a keeper, breaking a tackle. Into sailing territory. Dropped
in
about the 45-yard line.
Knew it. Brings him down. However, not until he got a first down at the 45.
Try to get some good defensive luck. Stops. Some of it's been by committee there, so it's kind of a pile of white there, and I haven't been able to pick some of these guys out. But
again, Christian breaking tackles. Just tripped up inside the 35.
Tanner Christian again for a
number. It looked like 33. Toby Holtz pretty much saved a touchdown there, I believe.
Toby Holtz makes the stop.
Shoestring tackle.
Then Dan Scotts.
Or early on here, Jerry Chris Tanner, he's a pretty tough runner.
Yeah.
He's not overly big, but looks like he's strong and not easy to bring down.
5'11 and 180 pounds.
That's pretty good size, but looks like a good strong runner. Doesn't go down easily. Our first real good look at these guys.
Kintzer breaks a tackle. He's got a first down inside the Well, not a first down.
Number 21, Bailey Kinzer, takes the handoff.
Good run on first down.
Number 4, Darren Burgess.
They're going to spot it at the 24-yard line, so a gain of 8.
Gain about 7, be 2nd and 3.
Again, Caledonia being very methodical here on the ground.
Yeah, they're not overly fast, but that's a normal. Take some time, put long drives together.
Hand off to Kinzer. Hit hard. He's going to be close to the first down. There
was number 21, Bailey Kinzer, gets the handoff up the middle.
See where they spot it.
Sitzma in on the stop. Officials timeout.
Official timeout.
So timeout a minute. Looks like you got a South player not overly
like
down. They're going to chat with him a minute.
Darren Burgess.
Well, one thing I was going to bring up, Jerry, too, it's early in the season, a little warm and humid tonight.
It is. The condition is going to be a factor for both these teams.
You know, South's down a little on numbers, too. I don't know how many, you know, you're going to watch how many people play both ways. And on a night like tonight, I was able to go watch a game last week. Same thing. It just looked like a team ran out of gas a little bit. But it's hot early on the season here when you haven't really got into playing shape yet. You've been working and running, but it's not the same as that game playing condition that you get in midway through the season until the end. You're still getting new bumps and bruises. Because at the end of the year, you just get them on top of one another and don't notice it so much.
There's a
flag before the snap.
Offsides, I think, against the defense, I believe.
It is. I think
dead ball.
It is.
Offside.
So that will be a Caledonia first down as a result of that 5-yard penalty.
5-yard penalty will give Caledonia a first down.
This drive alive. So first and 10 for Caledonia. Ball on the 17-yard line of the Sailors. Again, keeping it. It's inside the 15 and stacked up by that interior line of the
Tanner
Sailors.
Christian takes up the middle. Number 34, Dylan Brink, makes the stop. Gain of around 4. Be second.
Again, a good carry.
Yeah, they're getting, Jerry, it's the same look that they're giving you out of the spread as they give you out of their old wishbone style, too. It's they're running the ball out of the spread. Real methodical, picking up 3 and 4 yards. It's kind of a normal look out of a different set,
yes.
That's all. He's going to throw. He's got a guy open.
He's got him in. Just falls incomplete.
Christian's pass intended for number 86.
Cam Robinson.
Cam Robinson was the intended receiver, but just outside of his reach, so that stops the clock at 6:36. First quarter brings up third down for the Fighting Scots.
So we got a couple of downs here. Have to see what they want to do. I know they have a pretty decent kicker.
Yeah, Watrous is back.
Yep. He struggled a little bit last week. He missed a couple. That extra point thing always seems to be Caledonia's issue. They're going to spread them way out here. I'd be surprised if he runs out of this. Spread that defense out.
He's got the first down.
Close,
very
Jerry.
Close.
The five, which would give him that.
Inside the 10
and
yard
it is
line.
A first down.
First and goal.
Well, there you go.
It'll be first and goal for Caledonia at the 6.
Well, Jerry, that's the key with that spread offense. You get that defense spread out all the way across the field. You can't get everybody in the box to stop your run game, and you run out of it. Puts man on man, and you don't have the extra guy to block all the time. Very effective. Kinzer.
Fighting hard. Gets
Bailey
down to
Kinzer carries the ball close to the goal line.
1 yard
down
line.
To the two.
At the 2 yard line.
I'm not going to get
down.
The. Hunder. I'll wait until they score. I want to get the cart in front of the horse here because you could turn the ball over, but I'll. I'll wait and hold what I was going to talk about here a minute. I don't want to jinx anything. Still haven't put it in, so I don't want to. You want to rack the points up before you have them here. South's making a player change last minute.
A second and goal from the two.
They're going to stay spread out a little bit.
Skinzer is going to walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Caledonia. That score comes at the 5:15 mark of the first quarter and a 2 yard touchdown jump by Bailey Kinzer on a well thought out and played drive by these Fighting Scots.
Okay, now we'll talk about it in a minute. That's a long time on a hot night to be on defense, Jerry. That's hard at the beginning of this ball game to put that defense in that kind of position to make them play the better part of the first quarter on defense. So the typical Caledonia drive.
Watch us on for the PAT, and it's good. So our score, Caledonia 7, South Christian 0.
Your score with 50.
Well, all on the ground, again, just like we're used to seeing out of the wishbone set, but he did it all out of the spread. One look at wishbone on a short yardage play, but other than that, they stayed in that the whole way down. But it's much easier on a night like tonight to play offense than it is defense. That's just my opinion, but I think those guys were out there a long time getting pushed around, and that's the better part of the first quarter. That's going to be tough. We'll see how they respond to that.
Well, we'll see how Caledonia's defense does here shortly. Last week, Caledonia gave up an opening drive score to the Harper Creek, but they shut them out the rest of the
game. I was going to say, it was like somewhere in that 12 to 15 yards after that on the run game.
Yeah,
so they tightened right up. But
just shut down the Beavers of Harper Creek and see if they can't do that to the Sailors. We looked for the Sailors to throw
Austin
the ball
Luttress.
More than
will run. Tee it up and kick off for Caledonia.
Well, they certainly lost their key to that offense. Gary, you're right. And Wasnick, man, that was
he was an
extremely good athlete. Just one of those that comes along every so often. And he was good throughout his career. But
his watcher's kick, just a short
kind of a little pooch kick here.
Number 81, Chase Brink.
Brink
with
on
the
return.
South Christian.
Gets it out to about the 34-yard line. So, again, good field position for the Sailors to start their opening drive.
Well, Caledonia changed a lot of people to defense here, so I don't. They're not got a lot of people playing all the way around. You're gonna have some key spots that.
Number 55, Zach
took
Bull
a hit in graduation last year, but they, Caledonia's got a lot of good kids.
They got some good athletes here. Yeah, they'll be
there.
Fine. So. I believe it's Rogers and Quaker, I believe that's how you now say his name. So, yep, they're going to come out throwing.
And he's got to his favorite target. Newick. He's going to have a first
stop
down.
By Quaker.
Good for a South Christian first down.
And Drake Ellens.
Well, that was one of the combinations last week that brought South Christian almost into an upset of Grand Rapids Christian last week. The Sailors were down big, but Dexter
Quaker
discovered
Ellens
Newick out there,
the
and they
Scots
made a valiant comeback, but it fell short.
Number 11, Nate Hundred gets the carry.
Kinzer.
Hundred on the carry.
Bailey Kinzer.
He was thrown for a yard loss.
Behind the line, be second and 11.
A good quick defense. I was just going to mention before that play, I don't think they're going to have a lot of luck running the ball in this group. Going to have to throw it to get anything, I think.
Just getting time. intended for Newick, but out of bounds. Ball's incomplete.
Newick is out of bounds.
Allen's there for Caledonia.
Stops the clock with 4:03 to go here in the first quarter. Brings up a big third down and 11 for this Caledonia defense. Brian, it's a big key if the defense can get off the field.
Yeah, they put South Christian back on defense again. That would really put them in a bad spot. And they put a big drive together here and chew up the better part of the first half. Might be a little tough, but we'll see what happens here. Yep, they're going to send somebody. Got to hurry. He's got a man.
It is caught.
Dykstra to number 80. Newick. Good for a South
Again
Christian
on the reception. Well, they got him at 6'6", 6'7", and he's all of that.
So. Yeah, easily.
Big target.
We'll talk about that. It's a tough break.
Played some good hands early on here.
That's a tough throw, running to your left, throwing with your right hand. That's a tough throw. He put it right on the money.
Dykstra, the quarterback for the Sailors. He's just a junior. Probably got a lot of tutoring coming up from Wasink. Anyways, that is a Sailor first down, their second of the evening via the pass. It'll be first and 10 at the 43-yard line of the Fighting Scots.
Again, no, ball's out.
They got balls out.
He's still running with it. They blew the whistle, I think. I'm not sure why he's still running with the ball. I thought I heard a whistle, but it could have been me.
Dykstra ends up with a fumble, takes it to the 40-yard line.
Well, kind of a strange. Got stuffed at the line of scrimmage. The ball came out. Somehow Dykstra came up with it and got about 4 yards.
Stood him right up, but I thought I heard a whistle right at that time, but apparently not.
Second down. They'll say about 6 for the Sailors. Ball right at the Fighting Scott 40-yard line. Pass intended for Brady Viss.
Dykstra's pass intended for number 12, Brady Viss. Ball's incomplete, brings up third down.
That incomplete pass stops the clock at 2:54 here, first quarter. Caledonia on top, 7-0. South Christian started this drive at their own 34-yard line. They passed their way down to the 40.
Well, Caledonia's substituting down linemen right now too, Jerry. That's good. Rotating some people in and out.
Third down here. Again.
Well, somebody's got to wear him. They're giving him a little too much there in that zone setup.
Newick. Well, that's good for a first down.
Right now, Caledonia does not have a good matchup for Newick.
No.
They certainly don't have anybody that tall.
Oh, absolutely not. There's a lot of space out there. It's kind of a zone setup, and that's – boy, if you're going to give them 8 or 10 every time, that's not good. You have to –
it's like pitch and catch right now.
Yeah. And then he's got good hands, and quarterback looks – got a pretty good arm there too.
First down for the Sailors at the Fighting Scott, 32. This is intercepted.
Oh, he dropped it.
Oh, no, he dropped it.
I think he had it caught before it got to him. He read that he had that thing all the way.
Intended for Vanderpool, broken up by Zoet.
Well, Justin.
Second and 10.
Nearly pulled that interception in, so.
I think his eyes got big. Jerry had that thing caught before it got to him. Just a poorly thrown ball.
I think his receiver stopped on him.
It appeared like he slowed down just a little bit.
So anyways, I don't know if
the ball wasn't anywhere near him and he just decided to stop running. I don't know. I think they need to
spread formation,
get a little pressure on the QB here.
This time Dykstra on the keeper got maybe back to the line of scrimmage.
The ball.
It looks like Rogers, Jace Rogers, 25
good
on the stop.
Good tackle by Rogers. Read that play well. Actually, he came up with a loss on the play.
The third and 11.
Good job, Jace.
Looked like he 25 me, but.
So third down and 11. South Christian's been able to convert on their third down, you know, passing to Newick.
Yep, somebody better wear him here. They continue to play that zone setup right now. I think Caledonia Bryce Christian, who's only 5'8", is over there on him. And I think
it's going to be short.
Yeah, they'll go for it here. They're going to be about a yard and a half, 2 yards short.
Just pass complete number 12.
Spot the ball at the Fighting Scott 24-yard line, so it is going to be fourth down. And about
the fourth.
A long three.
And about three.
That sends somebody here. I put some pressure on him. If he can stand back there and throw, he's going to pick you apart a little bit. But see what Caledonia likes to do here.
Here we go. Fourth down.
I think South moved. I think it's
procedure call.
Procedure. That's going to change it completely here. Yep. Takes the run away.
Illegal procedure called against South Christian.
That backs them up five. So it'll be fourth down and about eight now.
Brings up about fourth and seven.
You still got to get some pressure on him, I think. That's looks like the key.
Clock starts, 50 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Big fourth down play still for these Sailors. And also for this Caledonia defense, they want to hold them here.
There's a flag down. Could be some holding.
Complete.
Gotta wait. That's coming back where the pile in front of the
flag on the play
quarterback area. So you're thinking maybe.
Did have enough for the first down, but we'll see what the call is. I think it's a hold, but.
We'll see. Holding South Christian, yep, you're right. Came in that area, so you kind of guess that that's.
So this is a big penalty. This is going to back them up. We'll see if they're going to go for it again here or just.
Or just elect to keep trying to get Caledonia back deep. Yeah, this turns into a punt situation here. They're going to punt the ball. Or make it look like you're going to punt the ball.
Two big penalties. Brings up
four
the South Christian
and
drive.
Long.
Yeah, I can't believe they're going to. Yeah, Caledonia's not going to. Their defensive set isn't believing they're going to punt the ball either here. They're just going to let it put no one back and keep everybody up. They might drift somebody. Yeah, they're going to send Ellens back now.
On to do the punting for the Sailors.
He's got to try to kick it away from him a little bit, I would think. But, yeah, a little. Yeah, that went short.
Very short kick.
25, 3, 2 yard line, somewhere in there.
Caledonia,
22 yard line.
Along with
Caledonia
the help of some costly penalties against the Sailor holds, so Caledonia will get the ball back at their own 23 yard line. And this shows 1 second left in the.
I believe that's what that says. Yeah, there's just that scoreboard's a little funny to read, but I think it's 1 second. It's a quick first quarter. Well, South Christian had the ball for a better part of 4 or 5 minutes there.
Yeah, I think the kickoff after Caledonia touchdown, I think it was 5:15 to go. They possessed the ball for some time, but no points.
Different here.
Kintzer is wrapped up right at the line of scrimmage.
Daly Kintzer, the ball carrier for Caledonia.
That's going to end the first quarter. A well-played first quarter by Caledonia.
Number 66, Justin Griffin,
Caledonia
makes the
top,
stop. Right
seven
the line of scrimmage.
To nothing.
And that is the end of the first quarter.
Well, right now, Brian, the wind isn't much of a factor at all tonight. Like you mentioned, it's a very hot and humid.
Yeah, down in the field, up we're way up high. And there's
100% humidity. It is really thick out there.
Not much.
Give these kids credit. They are well-conditioned. We'll see what they look like in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, we'll see. Like, yeah, exactly. What happens an hour from now, what they look like. But it's when you sleep good, right?
Yeah, it's one of these years, Brian, where Caledonia will have 2 football games in before school starts.
That's crazy, isn't it? It seems like every year it gets earlier and earlier, and all of a sudden there's 2. Pretty soon they'll have half the season in before they even go to school. I don't want to go back to school and it's 90 degrees outside anyways.
We're playing this on a Thursday night, and that's because of the upcoming Labor Day weekend.
Our most games tonight. Last week they kind of alternated a little bit, but again, most games were Thursday this week. Well, if the offense can have a similar drive again here, Jerry, they can take better part of the clock off. It'd be interesting to see if they change their look partway through this, just to see South Christian can adapt to a different set. But as long as it's working, you don't change it, right?
Right. Coming with a blitz.
Oh, nice block. Good pickup.
Christian still on his feet.
Excellent
block.
All that on effort.
Good block by Caledonia.
He's a shifty runner. He's impressive. He's a good runner, good all-around athlete.
South Christian came with a blitz. Caledonia picked it up beautifully. That's a very inexperienced offensive line.
Yeah, you're going to, inexperienced lines, you're going to see that not get picked up. But that group that's been playing together, they're going to be able to read those and pick those up. Christian again. A
nice
big hole.
He's just breaking tackles. He's in South
Tanner
Christian
territory. The ball
for another fighting Scott first
mark.
Down.
Good for a Caledonia first down.
You know, it looks impressive too, but I'm not number a fan of getting my quarterback hit every play either. So I don't know. He's a tough kid, but you're getting whacked every down. It takes a little wear and tear on you, especially on a hot night here. He's going to run out of gas here if they keep letting him run the ball. But
Kinser got a nice trap block there.
Bailey Kinser carries the ball.
Five-yard carry.
Darren
first
Burgess
down.
Makes the stop. Gain of five, be second.
Zane Gorby on
five.
A big block that time. He opened a hole that I think we could have walked through right now.
Yeah, might have been able to run through that. Gorby's coming out and getting the break here a minute, but
Caledonia.
Yeah, Gorby came out a minute. Get a
great job belting.
Yeah, that big group up front there. It's a good looking group. Very scrappy. The Gorby, extremely good wrestler. You know, all the way up through in the state wrestling meet there, and yeah, some good athletes here. We got to get a break. Part of this might be just a water break. You know. Get a timeout in.
Well, if we're hot up here, you can imagine what they are down there.
Yeah. It's warm up here. We got our water, you know. If you're working.
Always play defense when driving and be sure to wear your seatbelt. Traffic crashes are the number one cause of death for teens. And the best way to protect yourself from the tackle of the crash is to buckle up. No one wants to get tackled in a crash, so buckle up.
Aldering, and drive home James Doxey. Doxey's all at 230. I got to find Aldering here a minute. He's all of that size, too. Yeah, they're pretty good size guys. They're on that up front group right now. So, along with.
They're physical. They are one of the most physical offensive lines that Caledonia's had in some time. Again, Kinser, he's going to follow that line, but. A yard or so off the left side.
Bailey Kinsler, the ball carrier for Caledonia.
Third down and about five.
Brink and Rearink on the stop. Be third and four.
Straight ahead goes Christian. He's got the first down, still on his feet.
He's a tough runner.
Tanner Christian carries the ball. Good for a Caledonia first down.
They're going to spot it at the 37-yard line. First and 10, Caledonia.
Holst and Messling combined
10:05
for the stop.
Here in the second
first
quarter.
First and 10, Scots.
Go. Caledonia on top, 7-0, but they're driving again. started this drive at their own 23-yard line. They've worked it down to the South Christian 37.
I was just going to say, he's going to surprise him with a throw here in a minute.
Man open. It's Zod on the reception.
Tanner Christian's pass is complete to number 22, Justin Zoet. Number 18, Andrew Hahn, makes the stop for South Christian.
It's a first down at the Sailor 26-yard line.
From the 26.
You're right, Ryan, he was wide open.
I kind of wondering when Caledonia is just going to throw a pass in there quick. South's been just gearing up for the run. He'll throw it again, unless he can run it.
It's one man miss, makes another man miss.
Shifty, well, he's a shifty athlete. He's good. He's kind of fun to watch here.
Carrier, number 81, Chase Brink with the tackle.
Brink again on the stop, but he's pretty elusive. You're going to have to get a handle on him. He's going to be gone.
Well, it's going to bring up second down in about two. Yeah, 66, Justin Griffin getting a breather for the Sailors. He's a 6'1", 270-pound lad, so you know he needs a breather.
Yeah.
Inside handoff.
Kinzer kind of a little good blocking downfield.
Bailey Kinzer carries the ball. Number 18, Andrew Hahn on the stop.
Again, another first down for the Fighting Scots.
First down, Caledonia.
It's at the 13-yard line.
Just watching a little bit downfield. They're getting some good blocks downfield, too. If they can break a guy away, they got some guys putting some people on their backs. And in the defensive backfield area, too. There are a couple white shirts 10 yards from the play picking themselves up off the ground. So they're getting guys downfield, getting some good blocks in. Kinzer again.
Just following good blocking.
Following that side over there where Aldering and
Bailey Kinzer, the ball carrier for Caledonia.
Six
number 34, Dylan Brink on the tackle.
I think that's the size over there where Doxy and Aldering are. Jake Babb's in there up front, too. He's a good size, 6'3", 215. So, yeah, that's no matter who they're substituting in there right now, dear, they all are pretty good size.
Line of scrimmage for no gain.
6-7 is
Tanner Christian up the middle.
Well, third down.
Link and Brink.
Well, you got to think this is four down territory anyways for Caledonia.
Third and six.
Yeah. Robinson, he was a receiver that was targeted back in the first quarter, I believe, on one play there in the end zone when they got close.
Got Bryce Christian to the left.
And I think they're not happy with what they had called, so.
Timeout, Caledonia. Their second timeout.
Well, again, Caledonia chewing up a lot of time.
Yeah, we're
6:36
another 6 minutes off there again. That's crazy. Time of possession is going to be one of the water boys down there, too. He's got his crop duster there. He's got his sprayer, Mr. Unit, portable Mr. Unit. As long as he doesn't have bug killer in it. Better have a fresh one, right? You don't want to be spraying bug killer in there.
Take the one that says water.
That's right. That's it. Spraying those guys in the face there a little bit. That helps a little. Put a little cold water on a mist. Why not, right? Portable mister. It's not like the big leagues when you got the mister running on the sidelines on the bench. Kind of got to make your own. He got to about the five, I think.
He's going to bring up fourth down, though.
Number 33.
They're going to kick one here.
There to make the stop.
Well, they are sending watchers out here.
Brings up a fourth down for the Scots.
Well, you know, points are points, right? We've always talked about that a little bit. If they South would get a stop here, it would give you a little encouragement. See if he can put up three. It's always fun to see Austin field goals at the high school level.
Well, Bryce Christian will be doing the holding. It's a good snap. Kicks plenty of legs.
Looks like it's up and good.
From 23 yards out.
23-yard field goal.
Well, I got points of another long drive.
Puts three on the board. Caledonia 10, South Christian 0.
So that makes the score Caledonia 10, South 0. That field goal came at the 5:56 mark of the second quarter. Again, well over 6 minutes on
points
that
drive. Off a long drive.
Points,
yep, so points off a long drive. That's exactly what you're looking for. So,
more importantly, that's puts them up by two scores.
A little bit of a win for South's defense there by keeping Caledonia out of the end zone. But another long, sustained drive that took most of the points off, or the Caledonia, time off the clock.
Caledonia defense would like to pitch a shutout here in the first half. They had four straight quarters of shutout football going into last week.
Austin Watrous set to kick off for the Scots.
Which is a good sign when you look at Caledonia's upcoming schedule. This defense is...
Yeah, they're
going
to
up in a hurry, and they've been responded to the challenge thus far.
They're going
to looking good.
They're going to need them.
Another pooch.
Might have to lean on them a little bit.
Good coverage that time.
Good stop. 25 for Caledonia.
On the play.
Jace Rogers.
Good tackle by Jace, hustling
downfield.
Number
34, Dylan Brink makes the return.
There's a flag down there. We'll see what it is. Might be a hold.
Yeah, Rogers is going to stop halfway out a minute.
Oh, yeah, Jace is down.
He started over. He waved his hand like he wanted to come out. And then he kind of started back towards the hall, and he waved again. And
he's being attended to right now.
I think they told him just to sit down. I don't know if he got.
It's a sideline warning against South Christian.
Okay. So we figured the flag out. He's
sideline
up.
Warning.
And over here,
up.
I don't know if he may have got kicked. You took a heel. He got him from behind, so you never know.
Jace Rogers had the tackle for the Scots.
Kicked in the, you know, you get a leg come up and get you in the, under the chin strap there. They're kind of looking under his helmet.
Well, Sailor's back on offense. Starting this drive at the 34. Hondard. Got a couple off the right side.
Number 11, Nate Hondard, carries the ball for the
That's
Sailors.
Either 8 or 6, Nathan
Rory.
Rory
on
yep.
the stop for the Scots.
Rory. 8's a little scrunched from the front. I don't know if it's a 6 or an 8. But.
Well, Rogers back into the game, so he must be okay. That's good.
Rory, they've had at least 4 different people, like you mentioned, Jerry, kind of by committee there at the linebacker spot. So it's 4 different people they've had back there tonight so far.
And that's Massa.
Dykstra's pass is complete. Number 8,
first
John Massalink. Bryce Christian makes the stop. It is a first down for the Sailors.
Well, I'm kind of impressed with this Dykstra.
Yeah, he's got 47.
Pretty composed. Jerry doesn't get rattled too much. He's scrambling, throwing, running to his left for a right-hander. He throws pretty good. That's kind of tough.
He's just a junior. Again, he's going to keep, but he's got some blocking this time. He's going to be knocked out of bounds.
Eric Dykstra keeps the ball, carries for a first down. Number 1, Bryce Christian.
Well, he got a couple of good seal blocks on that. He found a nice lane, and
yeah.
That's a first down for the Sailors.
That could get interesting here if they could
done anything running the
put one in time. Here. With no time left. They'll get back within a score, 3 points.
Well, he was pushed out of bounds, which stopped the clock. 4:42 to go. until halftime. South Christian actually driving the football. They're down to the Fighting Scott 33-yard line.
That puts some pressure on him. He's just standing flat-footed back there throwing the football.
Brady Viss
to number 12, Brady
on the reception.
Viss. Good for a first
down.
Well,
he's mixing up his receivers. He's just not just throwing
knocked
a new
out of bounds
time.
By number 25.
Another guy's Rogers. Open.
Yeah, he's coming back in the ball game here. Number one target. You better know where he's at.
Yeah. Well, that's a first down again. Get the ball at the Fighting Scott 21-yard line.
Some good blocking. Oh, he threw a little bit behind the receiver.
Incomplete. Stops the clock at 4:13. The second quarter.
Dykstra's pass intended for Messling. Falls incomplete. Be second and 10.
Well, he's right now, Jerry. He took the snap and just took a step. He's just standing flat-footed and throwing the ball here.
He's getting a lot of time. Wide outs to the right, and I think we're going to have an encroachment
play
by the defense.
On the field.
It's going to go against Caledonia. There was a quick count there.
A little anxious.
Encroachment
yep.
against the Scots.
Probably changed his tone a little bit.
Yep. That's exactly what happened. It's going to bring up second down and 5 now. The Fighting Scott 16-yard line. A lot of time for these Sailors, 4:13 to go. Until halftime.
Hey, better look for, better,
keep an eye on
better
figure
out,
down
yep,
here.
Figure out where he's at, because he's looking right across the middle of the field. Get some pressure on.
We got another hold.
Wow, this coming back. It's a hold in the flag in the area of holding.
Well, this is what happened to South Christian there. The
last
first drive,
trip.
They got down deep in Caledonia territory. Got turned away by penalties.
Two big ones, yeah.
And this is going to be a really big one because they holding. Had it first and goal. Now it's going to be, this one's coming way back.
First and probably 15 or more. Way back out by the 30-yard line, I would. From the spot of the foul, is that where he's
holding against South Christian?
So 20, yeah, they're going to come way back here.
It's going to be a big play, but it's going to stay second down, though.
Yep, take the yardage, get him back to the. Yeah, it's a big drop. Yep, you're right, Jared. It happened to him last time. They moved the ball right down and got it inside tight and then made two big mistakes.
Hit by the penalty bug again.
And Caledonia's going to call timeout.
Timeout, Caledonia. That is their final timeout of the half.
Well, you would think defensively they know what's up, that you're running against the same offense that you run, so you get to see it all week. You're right, Jared. He said that Dykstra's pretty good.
Yeah,
pretty good athlete
South
himself.
Very,
yeah.
You know, for a rebuilding year, they're very competitive. And, you know, I got to realize, you know, they've stepped
game.
Up in competition. They're just a Division IV school.
South Christian defeated
Caledonia
by a
school.
Score of 26.
But,
he's got a
very competitive tonight.
Nice target there. Quick, and he's
48.
Looks like a pretty good athlete.
Well, you know, after last year's drubbing by these Fighting Scots, like we said earlier in the show here, that the Sailors went out to win a state championship. So
yeah,
and with the kind of talent they're showing here tonight, and
in their division,
they should.
Probably be pretty good. And they're well coached every year, too, you know.
Coach one of the best there is.
Yeah, he does a great job with them.
Big shoes to fill for Coach Blackwire over there.
Oh, boy, yeah. Tammy, he's done a great job with them.
He's done a super job for these Sailors.
It's good for them, though, for putting some Christian and Caledonia on their schedule early on, but that makes you better at the end of the year.
All right, Dykstra. He's got time. He's got a man. And guess who it is? He dropped it. Oh. Incomplete, they say.
Now, there's when you had to whistle right away.
Yeah,
I don't know.
That ball might have. Some raspberries here in the Caledonia side, but.
Be a third down.
Well, they're going to just call it incomplete. I was going to say, I don't know if he ever really had control of it. He might have been bobbling. A good call by the official. He's right on that over there. We can't see that far. We can, but we can't tell what's going on. I can see over there. Something's going on, but.
Well, third down and 20.
We could tell something's going on over there. Third and 20. Better watch where he's at. He's looking the other way this time. Got a receiver again, wide open.
It's going to be short of the first down.
To John Masalink.
Masalink on the reception.
Number 25, Jace
to
Rogers.
To about the 16-yard line. Rogers on the stop, but stopped him well
brings
short of the first down.
To the 15 at the 16-yard line.
Well, I don't know if South's going for a field goal.
Fourth and four.
Yeah, I would think they look like
they
are.
Going for it.
Probably thinking they need some points.
Yeah, well, it's,
so if they turn it over here, they're probably not going to get anything, and they're going to.
They need about 5 yards, and they are going for the field goal.
I don't know anything about Masalink as a kicker. We're going to find out. Well,
and
we got a timeout. And South Christian.
Grand Rapids, South Christian.
And we'll get another timeout.
Well, you got to be careful. Dexter's the holder.
I know. They're going to give you that look, but whether you believe that's what's going to happen or not, I don't know. Well, they got Masalink who can catch the ball and Dice can throw the ball. I don't know. Yeah.
Let's see if Newick's out there.
Yeah. Fady's out there. I don't know.
Because they wouldn't have him out there for his blocking skills.
No. Be a good time for something like that. Need a little momentum changer, whatever. If you're going to pull one out of your hat, you might want to think about it here. But
we've got a great crowd here tonight, Bryce.
Oh, yeah. No, there's both sides are full. Yeah, stands are full. Good to see. Good football. There's football game on tonight. College game on tonight, I think.
Who would that be?
Just Michigan. Is that one of the teams from Michigan's playing tonight? Yeah. I can't help it. I'm a Wolverine fan, so I.
I'm a Sparty.
Yeah, I know it. I know it. Everybody's they got to start that season somehow. Be interesting to see Michigan.
Well,
one way or another, they
game.
Needed a change. They really
sure
did. And,
they do.
Yeah. All right, we're back at it here.
Well, they are going to go for it. They
change their mind, yep.
Change their mind.
Probably just going to do Hail Mary in the end zone, right? Masalink's down. It's going to be close to a first down, though.
I think he got the first down.
He did. Well, there wasn't anybody over there. I don't know what they were thinking.
First in goal, South Christian.
Wide open. And as a South Christian first down. They went for it and got it.
Well, that gives them a little.
No putting these sailors, I'll tell you. You know, they gave Grand Rapids Christian, which has a very good football team, all they wanted last week. This time, Dutch's going to keep it, and he got nothing.
Might even have lost a yard. I'm not sure. He didn't think he got anything, did he?
Rogers was on the tackle.
Dutch keeps the ball. Drake Ellens puts him down just inside the 10.
Ellens helped out on the tackle, but they're going to say no gain. So first and goal. From the 8.
Yeah, Kinzer's complaining that he had a little. That's a size mismatch completely there. Our shortest defender against their tallest receiver.
Well, they got Bailey listed at 5'10". We all know that's not true.
Yeah, standing on a stool. Yeah, he's not. I can't believe he's 5'10". He's tough, but he just doesn't have any height. Yeah, he's matched up against Newick there. That's not a good deal. They put him in that over here. You got to wear him.
Tight formation this time. Dykstra was under center. He's got a man wide open. Touchdown, South.
81, different target.
They went
target.
To the tight end. They went to
Antonio Alcala.
They went him. Dykstra under center. I think that was the first time all night. And he went to the big tight end.
Yep.
And he was wide open, and South Christian scores at the 2:08 mark of the second quarter, tightening this game to 10-6. I think they're going to go for the 1 point after. Again, they're going to trot out Maslin for the PAT. Dykstra on the hold. Well, very nice drive by South Christian. A lot of guts going for it on 4th and 4, and they picked it up, and it was a key play of this drive for them. Kick is good, so our score.
An extra point good by Jonathan
Caledonia Messling. 10, South Christian
score
7.
Is Caledonia 10, South Christian 7.
Yeah, they, even with their mistake, they made the one big holding mistake, too, and they still recovered from that. They were way back out here at the 30-yard line and were able to grind it out, like you said, and pick that first down up.
Okay, you know, time of possession is all of Caledonia tonight.
Yeah, they've had the ball the whole first half.
And 10-7 score.
Yeah. Well, that was huge by South's defense to stop Caledonia in that last drive for 3, and then to come down and get 7. Like you said, that's pretty impressive.
And it gave their defense a little bit of a break. So.
Yeah, that's a. Well, they're a defense that. It's all in the air. I mean, they're not running the ball. They're throwing the ball on them. It's all. You know, it's all via the air game. So Caledonia to figure out a way to shut down that passing game.
Well, Hahn's going to do the kicking off for the Sailors. He's just a sophomore. He gets a squibber going. It's covered by Caledonia at about the 31-yard line.
Well, we'll see now. It's
kick is fielded by number 82.
We'll see a little more throwing the ball here, I would think.
Scots will take it over first and 10.
Covered that one up.
Not sure.
Well, plenty of time for Caledonia.
Yeah, there's a couple minutes. I don't know how many timeouts they've had. They used quite a few. You'd think they'd give them extra ones on a hot night, but. Well, they're staying their normal spread set up here. Maybe they'll be content. No, he's going to throw it.
No, he's got Ellens, but he's going deeper than that.
Christian's pass intended for number 16.
Watrous.
Watrous is incomplete. Be second and 10.
Stops the clock with exactly 2 minutes to go until halftime, but it's.
Well, you don't want to go too quick with those either. You'll end up turning the ball back over to South Christian with some time left.
About
Christian
the 35.
Carries the ball up the middle.
So this is a big third down here for the Caledonia offense.
Yeah, you won't give them. There'll be time left.
Seven.
With, if they have to punt from this distance, that's a leave South Christian with a pretty good defense here.
Brink and Griffin.
Or field position, excuse me.
Well, putting in Murphy.
Third
and
six.
Less substituting in there. Get some fresh legs for these Caledonia offensive backs. Wideouts. Sasso and Blitz are going to come with it. He's getting good time. He's going to be stopped short of the first down, but we've got a face mask.
Tanner Christian,
I think.
The ball carrier for the Scots.
We'll see.
Logan Heisinger makes a stop.
They got a
flag on the play.
You know, they're working on him on the sidelines. He's got to stop getting hit. I don't know who their other QB is, but he's.
Well, we'll see what the call is.
Silveri's the other quarterback.
Face mask penalty against South Christian. give them 5 yards and a first down for the Scots.
Again, a big penalty close against the Sailors.
Close to the 44-yard line with 1:06 left.
It's getting dark to me, but they don't have the lights on. That's why it's getting dark. I thought the sky was getting dark, but I can see the sun going down behind us, but they don't have any lights on. You have to figure that out here before we get too far into this game.
A lot of time left, 56 seconds. Christian, he's got a man, Allen.
Get out of bounds, yeah.
Tanner Christian's pass
inside
number 5.
Sailor territory at about the 48. That stops the clock with 48 seconds to go. Caledonia.
Toby Holt pushes him out of bounds.
Trying to get another score before halftime to answer that Sailor touchdown.
That's a first down.
Down to about the 41
yard line. Runs the ball. Tackled by number 68.
Well, just
Logan Heisinger.
Spike the ball here.
Good for a Caledonia first down.
Well, they got to stop the clock.
Yard. Stop the clock. They can spike the ball down and get some time here. This will just be, he'll just spike it.
Scott spiked the ball.
Well, brings up second down.
Second and 10.
Plenty of time, 35 seconds. Ball on the 41-yard line. At least maybe get it into field goal range or maybe get a quick touchdown.
Yep. See what happens here. See what they have up their sleeve.
Oh, he's gonna
that'll be that.
Tanner Christian. Boy. Pin in the backfield.
Two
by
guys
Heitzma.
Came clean for the Sailors, and then just
Holt
wrapped up Christian
down
for a big loss.
Yard line.
About a 10-yard loss, and now Caledonia's going to work that clock run down. Might go for a Hail Mary.
He may just let it run out. Yeah, they're done.
Yeah.
Coach taking his stuff off. They're going to let it run out.
Yeah. Christian took quite a hit there. He got pitched.
Yeah, he's banged up. Yeah, I think he's banged up a little bit.
Your Caledonia
well played first
10.
Half by both teams
South
come to
Christian
an end. Our score,
7.
Caledonia 10, South Christian 7. Surprising score. Considering the time of possession that Caledonia
had. We can go check on that. But
dominated the football game, but South Christian with that last drive. They only had 2 possessions tonight, but one and a long touchdown drive have tightened this game up.
I bet Caledonia had 20 minutes of possession time in the first half there. Better part of both quarters.
We'll
only 10 points, but South's done a good job.
Yep. See you at halftime.
Now on the field for tonight's halftime performances, the Fighting Scots marching band under the direction of Mr. Kyle Welfare and led down the field by drum majors Tyler DeVos, Nick Curry, and head drum major Adam McVeigh. The band is proud to present the season preview of our 2015 Show Through the Ages. Drum majors, is your band ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the Fighting Scots Marching Band presents Through the Ages. Thank you. Chase Brink fields the kickoff.
Well, much needed break for both those teams.
Oh, absolutely.
South Christian will have it first and 10.
Yeah, I could tell it was getting a little sloppy at the end, but South Christian started a little slow, if that's what you want to call it, but like you'd mentioned, they hung right in there and made this game pretty close. We'll see if...
Well, they were attending to Tanner Christian a little bit at halftime. You know, he had a lot of carries that first half. 17 carries for 95
yards. Yeah, we were worried about him getting beat up a little. I'll see what kind of adjustments Caledonia's made on defense here. You know, 8 yards of carry on our throw is just as good as 8 yards of carry on the ground. Those quick little dink and dunks like that are going to really, they eat up some yardage.
Brady Viss on the reception.
Gain of 7, 2nd and 3.
Sure. He's getting rid of the ball fairly fast, but we'll see if Caledonia can dial up some pressure. Oh, there it is.
Number 54,
Jake Babb. Really put a lick on the quarterback that time.
In the backfield.
Dyson elected the keeper instead of handing it off to Hondra. He paid the price there and lost on the play.
Down up the 41-yard line, be 3rd and 7.
Incomplete, so they'll bring up fourth down.
Pass intended for John Mustling.
Ball
incomplete.
Just dropped that one. Ball was right there. So it'll bring up a punting
broken
situation.
Up by number 24, Bryce Hauser. 4th and 7.
Allen's dropped back deep in Caledonia.
So that's what Cali needed. First series out here to get a 3 and out.
Drake Allen's back deep
South
for the Scots.
Time of possession.
No. No.
Andrew Hahn back in punt formation for the Sailors.
He's kind of a soccer runner. No, he's going to straight away it. Nice punt. Good punt. Some good block, and he's got some room.
Rick Ellen returns the punt. Over the 50, down close to the 30. Number 5, Jared Sitzma on the stop for the Sailors. 1st and 10, Scots inside the 30.
his coverage that
time. Yes, he did. That's what happens sometimes. You're right, Jerry. They had a couple of good blocks right at the initial part of that, and then it was a lot of green grass. Interesting to see if they stay spread or maybe change the look here. They will. That's right. They're going to give them the wishbone look here. And it'll give Christian a little bit of a blow.
Bailey Kinser carries for a first down close to the 18-yard line.
And Jerry, by doing that, that takes a little break for Christians. That's going to take a little pressure off of him running the ball so much out of that spread. So I would. So I thought they would change their look here a little bit and give him a break. Just hand the ball off versus getting smacked every play. Same thing again.
Bailey Kinser takes the ball, slips down close to the 15-yard line. Toby Hulse took him to the ground.
All right, watch him run a little misdirection here.
Second and five.
See if they run that counter. The ball at Kuypers here going the other way. Let's see what happens. Nope. Going to stay this way with Christian. Oh, he's going to spin away. He's going to get in.
Tanner Christian carries to the end zone. Touchdown, Scott.
Tell me what, Jerry, he's a hard runner. He just does not go down. He just keeps twisting, turning, spinning, driving. His legs, you can tell he's got strong legs. He's impressive, Jerry. He's going to have a good season here if they can keep him healthy. You can't run him all the time, but.
Watkerson's extra point is good.
Caledonia 17-7. Well, a little breathing room there. That
yeah.
Set up by that fine punt return by Ellen.
Yep, good luck to change that.
17, South Christian.
Change that offensive set there to give the ball to a couple other people. They got good blocking up front, like we mentioned.
Give credit to that defense, too. They held.
Yeah, three and out to start the half here. That's a good momentum builder, and then the offense comes out and right down the field. A lot of times, I know you give them decent field position, but that certainly stops the big return anyways. So if they stay with that style, or he kicks it away. He's going to kick this one away, see what happens.
Joe Vanderpool returns the kick. Number 23, Kyle Murphy takes him down at the 21-yard line. Sailors first and 10.
Well, now they got him pinned back a little, Jerry. They've been starting up around their 30, 35-yard line on that pooch kick. Now they got him pinned back just a little bit.
Caleb complete to Newitt.
Bonema there first.
Hauser and Rogers.
I think Bonema was the 24, I believe. Rogers was there. 24 is the other defender back there, so I'm going to stick with that. A little bit of pushing and shoving up the sideline there.
Pass intended for number 82, Joe Vanderpool, is incomplete. Drake Ellens back in coverage for the Scots. Third and seven.
So this brings up another big third down. Caledonia would love to get another three and out.
Yeah, they come down and score again with some more time off the clock. It really changes the outlook of the fourth quarter. Well, they've been able to convert some of these in the first half. Caledonia's defense can step up. And I think it's complete, Jerry.
Pass is complete to number 12, Brady Viss. Good for a first down.
Well, he does a good job throwing on the run, Jerry.
Gets rid of the ball, nice.
Got a good ball. He just looks like he's got a good arm.
From around the 39.
And he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Number 10, Eric Dykstra with the ball. Number 51, Daniel Barnett makes the stop.
Dan Barnett, he's a big guy, 6'3", 195. He's a sophomore, Jerry. That's Barnett's a sophomore. Good looking. That's good size. He's a good size guy there.
Intended for number 33, Toby Hulst, is incomplete. Third down.
And I'll walk this way. Side, your sideline's on the other side. Keep an eye on him a minute. Yeah, he's not.
Third down, third and 12. An incomplete pass off the clock. 7:52 to go, third quarter. Again, another big third down. Facing this Caledonia defense. Let's see if they can hold.
Probably got to watch the favorite target here. Here they come. Throws on the run again. A tip. Nice job by Bryce Critchin that time. All 5'10 of him. Got his hand on it.
For number 12, Brady Viss.
Intended receiver was Viss.
Broken up by Bryce Critchin.
Away by number one, Bryce Critchin.
South will be forced to punt again.
Fourth down.
Well, they're playing a little tighter and the receivers, Jerry, they're not giving them so much this time. They're coming up, playing them a little more in a man look than they are a...
Drake Ellen's back deep for the Scots. Han in punt formation.
Well, zone look, so...
Han again on for the Sailors.
Little better deal. See if he gets a good punt away again.
Does get another punt again. This one, Ellen's is going to take it at about the 25.
Yeah, this time they're going to...
He's got wrapped up.
Drake
no
Ellen's
game.
Fields the punt.
Corral him.
Number 82, Joe Vanderpool.
So Caledonia will have it first and 10 at their own 25.
Where it'll be Caledonia first down and 10.
Well, a little better job defensively here. We just, like I just mentioned, they're playing a little tighter on those receivers now and not getting quite so much area to roam in. And they're getting a little pressure on Dykstra right now.
Well, let's see if Caledonia comes back out in the wishbone.
They got to give Christian a little break here. He's getting rattled a little bit. Yeah, they'll stay in that bang and ground game out of that wishbone. Oh, he's going to throw out of it.
He's got a man out there. He's got him.
Well, we got a flag right here. See what this is about?
It's complete to Blake Swift.
Swift on the reception.
There's a flag on the play.
We'll see what it is. It's way away from the pass.
Sideline.
Warning against the Scots. Caledonia has it first and 10 at the 43.
So they just picked it up, gave the sideline a warning. Fighting Scots have it first and 10 at the Sailor 44-yard line.
They've been running right side. They need to go left here. Every play they've run out of that's been to the right. And I know they got their two best offensive linemen over there, but after a while, they're going to
no gain, be second.
No gain that time for Kinser.
Yeah, run the other way here. It's a misdirection or a counter out of this. They'll probably cut South Christian over pursuing. Nope, fullback.
Got maybe a couple to the 40.
It's always a good weapon out
Bryce
of that
Christian.
Wishbone.
On the carry up the
Bryce Christian.
Scots.
They'll give him about four.
Number 68, Logan
so
Heisinga.
Third down now for Caledonia.
Gain of four, third and six.
Oh, we got a flag.
There's a flag before the snap.
Looks like a false start.
Could be a procedure against the Fighting Scots. And that's what
procedure
it's
called
be.
Against the Scots. Back them up 5 yards.
Well, this will be a little different look here. They might.
Now it's third down and 11. Back to the 44-yard line. Caledonia's got to get to the 33 of the Sailors for a first down. 6:06 to go, third quarter.
Yeah, go back to spread. This gives a little option here. Like you can either run or throw out of this.
He's going to throw.
He's going to run.
He's going to be well short of the first down.
5 or 6 yards out of it.
Christian keeps the
well, I can't see him
Scots.
Punting here, Jerry. I got to believe. Well, Coach Burrell's going to go for it here.
Well,
they're going to spot it right at the 40-yard line. It looks like they are going to go for it.
Down at the 40.
See if they try to draw them off sides to make it a little easier.
Yeah, bark a little bit here and see if they can do a little freeze. It's a little tougher in the spread set, but... Yeah, there he is.
There he goes.
There's a flag on the play.
Well, that's the 5 yards they wanted
dead
to make
ball
this
and
a
that's
little
a,
bit
and
easier.
That's a guy that's way out on the outside, too. That's like a defensive end or something jumping way out. That's just a mental mistake. Yeah, this will make it a little easier. You wouldn't doubt they go back to their wishbone look. Jerry here with a little shorter yardage. That's what they come out in. A
couple of late substitutions going here for the Sailors. A little confused on defense. Again, Caledonia going with a long count. Zoet on the carry, but we've got a flag back here.
Justin Zoet.
I think this thing's coming back.
Good for a first down, tackled by number 8, John Masselink. There is a flag on the play.
He's going to get him for holding.
And Caledonia will end up punting this ball away.
Yep, got two now.
Well, holding penalty is going to nullify a fine run that time by Zoet. Would have been, looks like, first and goal is now going to be in a long fourth down situation for the Fighting Scots. And they're
holding is the call against
have to
the
punt
Scots.
It away. At least they're showing punt.
So fourth down, so left the punt. Well, there's a mistake again. South made a couple of them in the first half. Caledonia's first real costly mistake here, penalty-wise.
Watchers will do the punting. High end over end kick.
Pretty
away.
Nice kick. Got a nice roll.
And it's going to be down by the Fighting Scots at about the 6-yard line where South will have it. First and 10.
around the 7-yard line, where South Christian will start first and 10.
Well, one mistake.
Well, both teams held on to the football. They haven't turned it over, and I'd like to see a turnover right here deep in the Sailor territory.
Been a couple of close plays, but they've been recovered by offenses. But Caledonia's defense, first two series here in the second half, done very well. Put a little pressure on and playing the receivers a little tighter. Hard to throw under duress. Coming a little wider. He's coming again.
He's got Viss. This has got a first down, I believe, depending on the spot.
Pass is complete to number 12.
And it is.
Viss.
Well, that gets
Kyle Murphy with a
little bit more breathing room for Dykstra.
Good for a first down. First and 10 from the 19.
A lot of time in this one yet. 4:23 to go. Third quarter. Caledonia on top. 17-7. South Christian has displayed the ability to go the length of the field for a score.
Allen's with a nice stop over the far side.
Complete to Joe Vanderpool.
Vanderpool on the reception.
Ellens takes him down after a gain of about 4.
Just short of the 25-yard line. They'll give him 4 on the reception. Brings up second down. Well, Dexter had 90 yards passing in the first half. Seems like he had a lot more than that. But
yeah, I would have guessed a lot more than that. A lot of it's shorter stuff.
Overthrown, intended for Viss.
Dykstra's pass Newick, rather. For Newick is incomplete.
Newick.
Be third down.
Was well covered that time. So it brings up third down and about 6. And one thing, that incomplete pass stops the clock with 3:23 to go in third quarter. Got
Dykstra's
the first down.
Pass is complete to number 33, Toby Holtz.
Toby Holtz,
Kyle
on his
Murphy on the
first reception
of the
evening.
First and 10
is a first down.
Sailors at the 31.
Again, South Christian picks up a big third down conversion.
Yeah, they're chipping away here a little bit. Got the ball moved out past the 30.
Started at their own 6-yard line. A little bit more operating room here for Dykstra.
Again. Dykstra's pass complete to Vanderpool.
Vanderpool on
Allen's on the stop.
Quick pass in the flat, right flat. Got about
Gain
5.
Gain 5. The second and 5.
Dykstra's been very cool, calm, and collected back.
Pretty much so. Got a hot night. Yeah, he's done
a
pretty good. Yeah, the plays where Cali's getting some pressure, they might have some extra down people here helping with a little of that. It's not catchable. Overthrown. A big target.
Well covered that time by Zoic.
Is incomplete. Bryce Hauser back in coverage.
Incomplete pass stops the clock, but it brings up another 20, third down.
It looked like Zoic 22 and not Hauser, but Christian and
Zoic. Zoic was on the coverage, Third down and 5.
So another third down. Lots of time.
That's kind of late.
Dykstra's pass is incomplete. However, there's a flag on the play.
That was a late flag.
Well, it was kind of late.
That was
I went
Vanderpool
ooh right away because he made a pretty good play on that. You could hear his hand slap the ball. And we'll see once what the deal is. I don't know. Callie's clapping her hands. I don't know what the deal is.
It is pass interference against the Scots.
Wow. That's an interesting call. A little late.
I don't make anybody happy here on Caledonia's side. That looked like a well-played defensive play by the Caledonia back. Referee saying no.
So that's another conversion on third down.
As a result of that big penalty.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Now the ball's in Caledonia territory. They're spotted at the 49-yard line of Caledonia. That's where the Sailors have it, first and 10.
He's moving, but there's a flag down, but I believe 33 out here, the receiver, one of them guys was moving.
Yeah,
a flag way on the other side. I don't know why the official on this side didn't call it, but he had to have.
Yeah, that was a
somebody
movement.
Saw him moving. What they're pointing at.
Having a confab right now, but
well, he definitely moved. Yeah, he definitely moving
the
before
side.
The snap, but it's pretty easy to do. You can't wave that off.
They
waving it off. No, yeah, it's the coach. They got to have
that's wave off the flag.
Two big
they
plays.
Waved it off.
No, he's moving.
Well, brings up. Second down and 5.
Official timeout.
Well, the officials are.
Yeah, he's moving. I don't know.
Gonna have a timeout here.
About?
I don't know what they're talking about.
I mean, easily moved. They could see it, but can they wave it off and then call it again? I don't know. The kid's moving. It's pretty obvious.
They're having a long discussion.
He's going to have to go talk to the other sideline now because they've waved it off. So, because the official on the far side called
no,
it.
Review.
No.
Video review in high school.
They did throw a flag, though. I mean, the official on the far side threw the flag. So it's perceived there. They got it right. They got it right. Hey, you know, we pick on those guys, but good for them to take. I mean, it took a little argument on the Cali side. So now there's still something up.
Be first and 15.
Yeah, first and 15 now.
Well, good for the official to stop play and make and get it right. That good job. We like to pick on those guys, but yeah, they got it right.
Those zebras. .150 to go here in the third quarter. Dexter getting all kinds of time, and he's got a man up wide open. That's Hulse, I believe, again.
Pass is complete to number 33, Toby Hulse.
So
Hulse.
A big,
wide open,
Bryce Hauser.
Big play to get it right back.
Be a South Christian first and 10 inside the 40-yard line.
Shifting here by the Sailors.
They're all moving.
All
he's moving again. Yeah.
There's a flag before the snap.
They had like two or three guys going that time, so maybe it was a count thing. They didn't
yeah, they looked a little confused right from the start. You're like people jumping around and.
Procedure against the Sailors.
So that's going to make it first and 15 again.
So it looked a little out of sorts right from the beginning there. Got a little time of possession here, Jerry, on this drive. That's for sure. Like you're way back on their six.
Yeah.
Quite a bit of time. They're taking most of the time off the clock.
Yeah, they picked up some big third down conversions on this drive. Now it's first and 15.
They might have. Oh, Allen's had his hands on it, but got it knocked down.
Pass stops the clock with a minute 31.
Dykstra's pass intended.
So it's going to stay second down and 15.
be second down and 15.
Caledonia's doing a good job of rotating some of those defensive linemen in and out.
Still
difficult to get pressure on Dykstra. He gets rid of the ball so quickly.
Yeah, he doesn't take more than a couple steps. If within 3 seconds or so, he's throwing the ball, and that's pretty tough to get to him when that's happening.
This time they got him.
That time it was closer to four and you can't hold it that long.
Good rush up the middle by Caledonia.
Now they're just going backwards now, Jerry. They're way back.
James Doxy with
now
the
it's going to be third down and a whole bunch.
Be third down from the 47-yard line.
Well, they've got to get inside their own.
22
Caledonia,
maybe?
Well, 30-yard line. You got to get a first down.
I think they got it at third and 25. It's going to be third and, give or take in that range. They're a big play.
Screen action on a bubble screen.
They got it back to 12.
Passing is complete.
They're going
to number 12, Brady Viss.
They're going to go for it.
40-yard line.
Well, maybe they'll punt it and try to keep them deep.
Number 41, Jake.
Play field position, I guess. You know, it's only a two-score game, really. They're not out of it. It's two scores.
Well, they want to pin Caledonia deep.
Yeah.
Get a chance of getting a turnover.
Sure. It's probably good coaching.
Well, Han will do the punting. Caledonia's not sending anybody back right now.
Good call. We can make any kind of call up here, but he's going to.
That's the end of the third quarter.
Yep. There we go.
That is the end of the third quarter. Our score, Caledonia 17.
And that
South
is the end
7.
Of the third quarter.
A little different style third quarter there, Jerry. Caledonia came out in the wishbone, but then both teams moved the ball back and forth. No points. So Caledonia got the one score after that. South Christian did a good job again here, and then they made a couple of mistakes again, and I think that's overall tonight that's hurt them a little bit. A couple big penalties. I heard him in the first half. Sack here. A couple of plays.
That was a very fast moving third quarter.
Yeah, that went along real quick. So just a little different compared to the first two.
Well, the sun's gone down here at Ralphie Meyer Stadium, and it's taken a little bit of the heat away.
And the humidity's there, but at least helps a little bit.
Again, no breeze, so that doesn't help at all.
Yeah, the flags on the goalposts there are just moving around a little bit. And Caledonia's not even going to put anybody back.
Nope. Han's got a punt to nobody back there except the referee.
And so we're just going to let this one roll.
If it makes the end zone, and it does.
Yeah, it's going to go in the end zone.
Punt rolls into the end zone. Caledonia will start first and 10 from the 20.
20-yard line, and that's where Caledonia will have it, first and 10.
You still got to think they're going to.
Well, they're up by two scores. I think what you got to do most of all on this drive is take some time off this clock.
I would think they'd stay in that wishbone set, maybe just to grind it out and keep some of those hits off of the quarterback. They do change fullbacks just to give Bryce Christian a little break. He was playing there, I think, so.
Both ways. This time, Tanner gonna be laterals.
And he turned it over.
We have a flag down, but that was definitely a turnover. And I think the flag was going to be against Caledonia. And I think South Christian's recovered a fumble. We'll see.
I'll see what the flag is, unless it's defensive.
They're talking
penalty.
It over right now.
Is it a defensive penalty? That's probably what they're discussing. If it's a defensive penalty prior to the fumble, I believe the possession will stay. Is that right?
That's what they're talking about right now.
I can't totally be sure. It's a shift. Yeah, defensive penalty. Oh, so the ball should stay.
And it'll be Caledonia first down.
Yeah. Wow, that was a break.
Illegal for Tippis. Too many men on the field for South Christian.
So Caledonia dodges a bullet there. Wow.
It gets pretty crazy when you're scrambling and you pitch the ball and do some crazy things like that. But
so it's going to be first and
five. They did make something out of it, though. It's interesting to watch anyways. Yeah, they'll stay in the ground attack here. Counterplay.
Not much off the right side on that counter.
Eight, set the ball carrier.
Gets the call.
Six or eight? Yep, six.
Toby Holtz.
Peyton Dumas on his first carry of the night. Got a couple.
Be second and four.
Second down. Long three for Caledonia.
Yep, stay with us. Christian, nice play. Going to pick up a first down.
Got a first down.
Tanner Christian Eight. Keeps the ball up the middle. Good for a Caledonia first down.
John Messling
makes the stop.
Keep those chains moving. Keep that clock running. First down, Caledonia.
First and 10 from the 34.
Christian on the keep. Gets near the 40.
Good 5-6 yards.
Christian, the ball carrier. Dylan Brink on the tackle. For
Brink.
South Christian.
34 for South on the stop.
So that'll bring up second down. Good game that time.
Second
by
down.
Tanner.
And four.
Give him six on that carry.
Hey, Jerry, with 10 minutes left in the game, this is where the line, one of the two lines, is going to show some fatigue, I think. Ball's out. See what happens. South Christian thinks they have it. They do. Well, that's
coughed
huge.
It up. There's a first turnover.
Ball was fumbled. Recovered by number 70, Bryce Reynolds, for the Sailors.
First and 10 from the 40. The Sailors at the Fighting Scott 40-yard line. Well, that's a turn of events.
That's huge. Just under 10 minutes to play. That's a lot.
Caledonia looked in control there on this drive that started at their 20, but they just coughed it up. Not sure what happened. The ball just came out.
Yeah, it looked like on a handoff. You had a little miscue there. It looked like you had a little, gave it to him a little high. Up by the shoulder pads.
Stiffens is
Dylan Brink.
100 got
carrier.
A yard or two. He's not been very effective tonight. Caledonia's wrapped him up pretty good.
Yeah, they're not anything. I'd be surprised to see much yardage on the ground. It's all come through the air.
Stop for the Scots.
It's all through the air.
Well, that brings up second down and 9.
I think, Allen's had his hands on it. I think Newick had to turn into a defender there, Jerry.
So, nice job. Got another flag down. We might have
back in the holding area, too, because he threw that under duress again. I got to think there's some holding. That's usually where that flag comes from, in that area. But they're talking it over again. Probably where the ball needs to be spotted. Should be personal foul, Caledonia. Wow.
Might have been, I think a late hit.
A late hit on the quarterback. Yeah, that makes sense then. Sure.
personal foul, roughing
the passer called against the Scots. That's a 15-yarder, so that's first down.
Well, that's a big penalty, too.
First and 10 inside the 25.
It's a huge penalty. There's a lot of time left here, Jerry, with 9 minutes to play, and South on the move inside the 25.
They're deep in Caledonia territory now. He caught it inside the five.
Did he?
No, they're going to say incomplete.
No, the official on the other side waved it off.
Yeah,
he's rolling on it. That's pretty low. I think he waved it off, didn't he? Did the other official wave it off?
I thought he did, but, you know, the official right on the spot said he caught it, so they've got it first and goal at the three. Hulse didn't make it back to the line of scrimmage.
Dylan Brink, the ball carrier.
Stopped by Bryce Christian.
Bryce Christian.
Christian on the stop.
Tackles him around the 4-yard line. Second and goal.
Last time these guys, Sailors, were down here, they went with Dykstra under center, but they're going to keep them back in the spread. Got to about the one, so it's going to bring up third and goal.
Well, that's two down territory here, there's no doubt.
Carries the ball up the middle, irons and others, and on the stop.
The thing you do here is so for maybe a miscue on the snap exchange or something.
Well, this is big here. He didn't get it. Gonna bring up fourth down.
The ball carrier, Jason Rogers.
Jason Rogers with a big stop there.
And goal.
Nice stop by the linebacker that time, Jerry. Read that, stepped right up and filled the hole quick. Well, here we go. This will be a big stop here. That'd be interesting to see what they do here.
They might
now you know
go
this.
For a field goal. Maybe. We'll see.
But you need points.
No, they're going to go for it.
Yeah, it's late in the game. You're probably going to need the big score. At some point, you've got to get something. So this is a little bit of a chance.
Well, crowd to their feet. They know what's at stake.
Yeah, incomplete. Got to stop.
Thanks for catch ball. Incomplete in the end zone.
Caledonia
holds first and 10.
Well, that's a huge stop. You're in a big turnover. They stopped them with no points. Playing a hot night late in the game. That's a gutty performance by that defense.
Can't afford another turnover this deep. You got to get the ball out of here. Get a little working room here for this Caledonia offense.
Well, Christian gets a little bit of running room there.
And a little breathing the ball room. Carry up over the 5-yard line.
Gets out to about the 6.
Logan Heisinga, and on the stop. Second down and 6.
Well, if they can grind out a first down here, Jerry, that would be really big.
Well, we've got 6 minutes to go.
I'll just grind out a big long drive, but another first down here would be huge. Yeah, there it is.
Chains will move and the clock will run.
Tanner Christian carries the ball. Good for a Caledonia first down. Toby Hulse made the tackle.
Caledonia going to stay in the wishbone.
Another good gain.
Justin Zoet.
Saw it on the carry.
The ball carrier tripped up by Dylan Brink.
Brink. And Burgess for South Christian.
Good gain on first down there.
Yeah, you like to see that 4 and 5 yards on first down out of that power run set there. That's
Caledonia, no hurry here. They're up by 10, 17 to 7, 4:55 to go. Christian surveying the situation.
Fullback.
Fullback's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up third down.
Bryce Christian, the ball carrier.
With Bryce Christian on the carry. No gain.
Brink makes the stop for no gain. Third down, 5.
A third down and 5. This is a big play here for Caledonia.
And I want to punt it away again. There's a lot of time, 4 minutes. Quite a bit of clock left.
Tanner
Keeper.
Keeps it, but he's not going to be close to the first down. So Christian Caledonia more than likely
carries
will
the ball for the
punt this ball away.
Well, it's a gutsy play here. They're not.
Fourth and 2.
They're not tipping their hand like they're gonna not go
Griffin
for this.
And Westendorp make the stop.
Unless they're gonna let the clock get as much time off the clock as possible and call timeout, which I think they're gonna do. Let take as much time off here. They'll call a timeout and then punt.
Winding down to 3:30.
Yep, timeout.
Timeout, Caledonia.
Well, see, I wonder if they're talking about they can get 2 yards here. I mean, their defense made a big stop.
Well, you think they can get a first down here, they can run out the clock.
Yeah, that's what I'm sure that's the discussion here.
They got a full 2 yards to go, Brian.
Yeah, this is a tough call. I've seen them do this before deep on their own territory on occasions, but we'll see what they decide to do. I don't know if I see the kicker out there, do you?
Watchers usually does the punting, but I don't see him anywhere.
I think they're putting their offense back out there. It's a pretty gritty call here.
Yeah, I think they're going for it. South Christian.
Well, are they going to draw him? Or are you going to go hard count and then?
Yeah, South Christian don't realize it yet.
Yeah, they had a guy back, but Kelly's offense is out there, and they got a guy back thinking he's going to get a punt. Yeah, he's probably going, what in the heck? I'll see if they can get him to come off sides. Yeah, and he's going to go. Yeah, that's it. Just pick it up. Don't try to, don't fall on it. Don't try picking that thing up.
Well,
that was a big play.
Caledonia.
First down, Caledonia on a huge play on fourth down.
Andrew Hahn made the stop for the Sailors.
Well, that's a huge play, Jerry. You know, how many times you've seen that, though, on a fourth and short, everybody bunches up, and once you break that line of scrimmage, there isn't anybody, and that's just got a good block up front over here. Good job by the left side of that offensive line.
Well, first and 10, Caledonia at the Sailor 17-yard line. Caledonia, no hurry. They can just get another first down. This one will be in the books.
I think that's Doxy and Aldering over there. Made a nice hole.
Christian and the keeper, and there he goes. Touchdown,
Tanner
Caledonia.
Christian spins, takes
Tanner
the ball.
Christian on a 17-yard sprint into the end zone.
Puts
Caledonia on top, 23-7. That score comes at the 2:40 mark of the fourth quarter, and that one ices this one.
Pretty much going to do it. Two big blocking plays over there on the left side. Doxy Aldering, nice job. Well, Jerry, is that the fatigue factor on the defensive side for South Christian? Caledonia's line just been...
A little bit of deflation there on that last game.
A little bit of both.
After that big fourth down play by Caledonia. They knew the game was over, basically.
Yeah, a little bit of both, maybe. That gutty performance, though. South had this game well within...
There's a flag.
Well, that fourth down, the goal line stand by Caledonia came up big.
Yeah, South had some chances here to really make this game very, very interesting. They've gutty, you know, to keep that game close at the half, and then...
12 men on the field for the Scots.
Got a big turnover, you know, in the opponent's end, and really tried to... They were there, just a couple of mistakes and maybe just a fuzz out man. It's hard to say, but they did make a couple mistakes. But
Marches kick.
I think it's, nope, he missed it.
Good.
Just a little bit
left.
But
left.
Not on top of the mistakes, but then the big defensive stand by Caledonia down here.
Caledonia 23, South Christian 7.
Multiple shots inside the 5-yard line there, and just... The defense stood up to it and got it done. So they did a great job.
Well, the one thing you can't do is let South Christian get a quick score.
No. And they look like they're capable of that, though, Jerry. They really are. They just haven't been able to get them completely broke free. But
well, we've seen stranger things happen, Brian. You know, it's never over till it's over.
Oh, no, that's for sure. This is, Aldering was down. He's being helped here a little bit. He was down after that last play, and he was
for South Christian.
I'm not sure what happened to him, but he certainly made a couple of big holes over there on that left side.
Could have been cramped up.
Well, something's up with him.
Another pooch kick. It's out to about the 37-yard line, so at least decent field position for South Christian, but the thing that's going against them now is the amount of time left in this game.
Returns the kickoff. Sam Glass makes the stop.
Nice job by the offensive line, too, here. Good job.
First and 10 Sailors from the 37.
Both groups have asserted themselves here a little bit in the second half, the offensive line, the defensive group. Looks like the defender fell down that time. I think Zoet slipped over there.
Pass complete to Brady Viss. He steps out
Brady
of bounds after he gains a first down.
He's had a good night, yeah. They've kind of quieted down Newick there. He was the main target in the first half.
Yeah, well, Brady Viss is just a junior, too, so him and Dykstra will be back next year.
Yeah, Newick, he's become a non-factor here in the second half.
Justin Zoet knocks him out.
Caledonia's been doing a little bit better job of watching.
South Christian.
Yeah, playing him a little tighter, knocking him at the line of scrimmage a little bit. Keeps them, get them out of their pattern. That's the other thing, too. Dykstra does a nice job, but you got, if your receivers run good patterns, it helps a lot. He's looking for, no, he's going to go back across the middle. Ball out. He's just going to call it incomplete. Never had it.
Nice break up that time by the secondary.
Pass intended for Messelink. Ball's incomplete.
Maslink had it there, but Caledonia sharply knocked it out of his hands. So the ball fell incomplete, stopping the clock with 2:20 to go. Second down and 10 for the Sailors at the Fighting Scott 39.
Pass complete to Massalink. He steps out of bounds around the 33-yard line. Be third and four.
Third down. They'll give him about 6 yards on that reception. Going out of bounds, stops the clock.
Another quick hit over there. Ball's loose, complete. Big hit. I think Zoet. Broken up Zoet.
So this is going to bring up fourth
brings
down.
Up fourth down and four.
Looks like a completion over there, isn't it?
It does. It's a first down, and it is. Boy, he just got it.
Pass
so.
To Brady. This is complete for a
Viss
first down.
On the reception.
Inside the 30-yard line for the Sailors.
Stops the clock as they move the chains.
Great coverage that time. By Bryce Hauser, 24. He's running right with Newick there.
Yep. He was all over him. So it's going to bring up second down.
Bryce
and
Hauser.
10. Minute 56 to go. Clock is stopped on that incomplete pass.
No, it's not catchable. It's a good call.
Again, Newick, the intended receiver. He hasn't done much here the second half.
Intended for 80. Newick is incomplete. Be third and 10.
Well, third down now.
Well, Kelly's defense has had South in several third and long situations, and they've been able to get most of those.
Time, but short of the first down.
That's a nice catch. Pass complete to Andrew
Viss. Ohan, 18.
Yeah. Makes the stop.
Saw the one. I figured it was Viss again with 12. But
Han's just a sophomore, so he's getting some value.
Yeah, they'll have some good receivers coming back for him. Oh, ball out.
Caledonia's going to take over on downs.
Peyton Quaker for Caledonia there to sack him after the fumble, along with Gorby.
Gives the Caledonia Scots first and 10.
Well, we'll see Caledonia probably just go to a knee here.
That would be
nothing
the
fancy. A minute 21 to go.
Yeah, it should be. Give him a break here a minute.
Timeout.
Yeah, you're right. That would be the. It's been a good football game, Jerry. Good, you know.
Yes,
South Christian's been pretty scrappy this whole game. They've hung right in there, short of just a couple things.
Well,
this might be a different ball game here.
Well, that's a good defensive effort by Caledonia tonight.
Here the
South put up four touchdowns last week against a very good Grand Rapids.
Christian, yeah.
Caledonia.
Second half here, they've done a little. Little nicer job.
Yeah, they've done a real nice job.
Keeping things under control. Giving them that real short stuff, nothing big. Like I said, Newick, he's kind of become, he was a non-factor here in the second half where he was.
They
lit him right up in the first half, but yeah, they've really shut that down. Yeah, the class thing to do here, just like you said, take a knee and let it run.
Thank you.
see what happens. They're still in their regular formation. They're not in there. No, they're going to run him. No. That's a touchdown saving tackle by
the ball carrier for the Scots.
33 Holtz, or we might have been looking at another score at the end here, but.
Gain of 9, be second down and 1.
Well, we're under a minute. Caledonia firmly in control of this one.
Should be able to go to a formation and just drop it down. They'll stay in their normal set, but he could just shouldn't have to. Oh, they're going to run a play.
Gets it out to midfield.
Justin Zoet carries the ball. Good for
him. Well, now it's coming. Yeah. You got to think here.
We might have time for one more play. That would be it. But
Justin
clock
is
stopping 37
stop
seconds
there
as they move the chains. Very impressive victory for Caledonia. They're going to bump their record to 2-0.
Yeah, here
next
we go.
Next week, we got an OK White Conference game coming.
East Grand Rapids.
East Grand Rapids Tana Pioneers.
Christian takes a knee.
Coming to town. And that's going to do it. That's our final. Caledonia, a very impressive victory here tonight. 23-7 over the South Christian Sailors. Give the Sailors credit. They were game tonight. They were very competitive. They got a young
team. There's the final. Caledonia fighting Scots 23. Grand Rapids.
I would think so. You mentioned that right at the beginning of the game, Jerry, where you said, you know, last year, same thing happened. They got beat up, but a tough schedule at the beginning, and that prepares you, you know, for later on. And you watch. They're going to rattle off some wins here. This is a scrappy ball club.
Oh, yeah.
They're very impressive.
They're a Division IV school, so they're going to be very, very competitive at that level. And in their conference, they'll be
I would think so, yeah. Look for them to do good things. They're well coached, well, you know, so you know they're going to have success there. But good on the Caledonia side, good effort all the way around.
Well, we've got some tough games coming up in our schedule. We've got a tough East Grand Rapids team coming. Then that's going to be followed up by state Division II finalist, Mona Shores.
Oh, boy, that's rough.
And historically, the last couple of years, we haven't matched up well
against them. No, not at all.
They're a very physical team. We know that. But Caledonia is very physical this year, too. So we've got some great football games coming up.
That's nice to have a few more home games this year and be home in a row.
So,
but
again, congratulations to these Fighting Scots and his coaching staff. A well-developed game plan, executed game plan. And you couldn't ask for anything more. But opening victory here for Caledonia for the 2015 season. Again, we'll see you next week. I'm Jerry Hoover.
Hey, Brian Bennett.